This YouTube Pod Smasher can generate hundreds of shorts by clipping long-form content on autopilot. These shorts enable creators to expand their reach dramatically.
The reason to even have a podcast is more about the clips for organic social than the podcast itself. I literally did Daily V for the social media clips, not for the long form.
That's why Whoop created the Content Reward Program. It pays editors huge amounts of money to clip long-form content into shorts.
There's people making bank by clipping. Clippers that are making thousands of dollars a month just by clipping other people's content.
By the way, this short was actually clipped by my automation. And yes, it's true that good editors are expensive and hard to find. That's why I built this YouTube automation without code in n8n. n8n is a powerful and easy to use no code tool that just requires drag and drop. And to take this automation to the next level, I will also show you how to auto publish these shorts. But if you want this automation just quickly up and running, join my community and download the template. And without further ado, let's get started. Before I show you how to build this automation step by step, let me show you first how it works. Everything starts with a simple form. Let's click test workflow. Here you just paste in the YouTube link and how many shorts you want. I found a cool video of Kevin O'Leary talking about the future of AI.
I think AI is going to be huge.
It looked like a great video that could go viral. So I copied this URL here and pasted it in this form. Since it's a 25 minutes long video, I think we can easily get like 4 good shorts out of it. So I type in here 4 and click submit. This starts the whole automation. Now here's what happens behind the scenes. First, the audio from the video is pulled out and turned into text. Then AI reads that text to find the best parts with hooks, surprises, or strong reactions. It takes those top moments and cuts them into a short video. These clips are the most exciting parts of the full video. Next, the clips need to be resized. The original video is in a wide format, but we want a vertical for TikTok and Reels. So another AI moves things around so the main person or object stays in view. Then it adds a nice caption that pop on the screen. At this point we have the drafts of the shorts. But we still need to export the final videos in high quality. But first we need to wait till the analyzing part finishes. This step now exports all the shorts in high quality. After exporting, we need to plan when each clip will be posted, and we do that here in the compute schedule node. This node picks the best days. Right now, it's set to post one short per day. If you want to change the schedule, that's totally possible. Inside my community, we go over how to do more advanced setups in a simple way. Then we track all the shorts in the Google Sheets document. Finally, we send the clips and dates to Blotato. It's a service that takes care of reposting the videos at the right time. And that's it. Now let's go to Blotato and see what got scheduled. Under calendar, we see now on the upcoming post when we reload the page that all our shorts are now scheduled. All with different captions for the different platforms. All right, let's see the results. For that, we go to our Google Sheets document where we saved all the shorts that we created.
It's not so much hobbies, it's challenging yourself in something that you do. I build those. And we can't get the power. I don't care what state you go to. You go to the power authority there and say, I need the...
You see the automation picked a really, really nice hook that makes the viewer directly interested. And all without any manual input from us. What you also might notice is,
so when I watch know this you clip, are a big watch guy. You're wearing...
The captions are really nice. They're always showing the word that's currently spoken.
Two watches right now. And I recently saw this clip of you.
It changes also perfectly between the characters depending on who's speaking.
Wearing an Apple Watch.
Well, the only problem with it wearing an Apple...
All right, let's build the whole thing. For that, we go back to our n8n dashboard.
If you're new to n8n, just create an account. You'll see the same dashboard as me. You don't need any experience to follow this tutorial.
And click create workflow. First, let's give this workflow a name like AI clipping automation. Next, make sure to open the Google Docs document you can find in the description box below, because here you can find the snippets and other materials that you need to follow along for this tutorial. The first step we have to add is a simple form. We click here add first step. and select under on form submission this one. For the form title, we choose clipping, automation, description we leave empty, and then we add our first form element. Our first form element is a YouTube URL. So we type in here YouTube URL and leave the element type as text. We make this a required field and add the next form element. Our next form element is how many shorts we want to create. How many shorts? Question mark. And here we select an element type number. That's it. We can go back to Canvas. Now let's test our workflow. Perfect. Our form element works. We are using video about future of AI as our test case. We type it in here. To keep things simple, we start by generating two shorts. The APIs we use come with a small usage-based cost, fair when you see what they deliver. Make sure to stay until the end, where I'll break down the full cost of this workflow. First, we need to create an account at Clap app. For that, we go to the Google Docs document and open the URL. This is the platform that analyzes long-form videos and automatically generates short-form content. To create an account, we click Get Started and fill out our information. Once we confirmed our email, we click Login and scroll down to this page, and under Services click API. Here you click New API Key. At this point, you need to enter your credit card details. You're only charged based on what you actually use, and the pricing is designed for creators running real workflows. So just enter your payment methods and click Subscribe. After you enter the details, you'll see your API key here. If not, click again Services and then API. Copy this key and either save it somewhere safe or keep the tab open. We'll use it several times. Now we are ready to use Clap API inside our n8n. First, we want to send the YouTube link to the Clap app so it can analyze the video and generate short form content ideas. To do that, click the plus icon here and type HTTP and select the HTTP request node. Next, go to our Google Docs document and copy the first snippet that you can find under Analyze Video. Go back to n8n and click Import Cure. Paste it here and click Import. Here we scroll down a little and replace the placeholder your API key with our actual API key that we just got from Clap app. Then we continue scrolling down here and under JSON we click Expression. Then we click this little icon here. Now we have to replace our YouTube URL placeholder here with the actual YouTube URL that we can find here on the left side. We also have to replace the target clip count and max clip count with our actual clip count, how many shorts we want to create. For that, we remove the one here and drag and drop this element here. And we do the same for max clip count. So an expression is basically a smart way to automatically fill in or adjust information based on what's happened earlier in your workflow. So basically we were submitting a form before, and now we can adjust the information that we send to the Clap app based on what we typed in before. And again, be mindful how many shorts you want really to generate, because you're billed per short. So choose your number intentionally. Again, stay with me to the end for a full cost breakdown of what this will cost. Once we finished here, we close this window and are ready to click test step. When everything worked fine, you should see here next to the output a check mark and an ID and the status processing. This basically means we successfully sent our YouTube link to the Clap app to get analyzed. In this example, we are paying 44 cents to analyze the video plus
32 cents
per short. So with two shorts, that's
$1.08 in total.
Plus a small export fee, which we will handle next. Important, since this calls cost money, we want to click this icon to pin this data. This is important so we don't have to rerun this step that will cost money to test further steps in this workflow. And the last thing we want to do is to rename this node. We take the same name like we have here, Analyze Video. And go back to Canvas. After creating the task to analyze the video, the next step is to check the status of that task. To do this, click the plus icon and search for HTTP and click the HTTP request node. Then go back to our Google Docs document and scroll down to check status. Here we copy and paste the snippet here, go back to n8n and click import curl and click import. Under URL, we click expression and remove task ID. The task ID is this one that we can find under analyze video. We drag and drop it here. Then we scroll down here and replace again our API key. Now click test step. As you can see, the status now shows ready. Let's go back to Canvas. To make sure the workflow only continues when the task is actually ready, we need to add an if node. This will check whatever the status equals to ready. For that, we simply drag and drop the status here and say is equal to ready. Then we click test step. And we see on the output it says true branch because the status is actually ready now. We go back to Canvas. But if the status is not ready yet, it's processing, we want to wait like 15 seconds and then recheck the status again. This loop continues until the task is ready. One last thing we want to do is to rename this node. Let's name it like in a Google Docs document, check status of analyzing video. And also pin the status so we don't have to rerun this step. And go back to Canvas. Once the status is confirmed, we can move to fetch the short form video's ideas. For that, we click the plus icon, type in again HTTP, and select HTTP request. Then we go back to our Google Docs document and copy and paste what we have under Get Shorts Ideas. Click Import Curl, paste it here and click Import. Under URL, we click Expression, remove the output ID here and drag and drop the output ID we can find under the if node. Next, we scroll down here and replace again our API key. Then we can click test step. And like you can see here on the right side, when we click on schema, we see we have two items. Since we have two shorts, we have now two items. In each item, we have the following information, like the name of the clip or the virality score. We also have the different captions for the different platforms, and we have a full transcript of this short. And the most important thing is the short ID that we need in the next step. Let's rename this node and go back to Canvas. Let's click save to save the current state of our workflow. Once we've got our short form ideas, it's time to turn them into high resolution videos. To do that, click the plus icon again and type in HTTP request. And let's name it create high resolution short. Then let's go back to our Google Docs document again and copy and paste this snippet here and click import curl. Under URL, click again expression and replace the placeholder for output ID, short ID. Short ID you can find under Get Shorts Ideas, the ID here. Last but not least, again, replace your API key here and click test step. This step runs at 48 cents per short. So with two shorts, we're looking at 96 cents for this part. Before we move on, make sure to click the pin icon here. That way you won't need to rerun the step each time you test the workflow. Then we go back to Canvas and we need now to check the status of the export. To do that, we click the plus icon again and add another HTTP request node. Let's go back to our Google Docs document and copy and paste the snippet under Get High Resolution Short. And click import curl and paste this here. Here we need again to go under URL and click expression. This time we need again to replace the output ID that we can find in the if node. Then the short ID that we can find under Get Shorts Idea. And last but not least, the export ID that we can find under create high resolution short. The ID, we drag and drop here. Then we scroll down here again and replace our API key. And click test step. Like you can see, we have now two items ready, and under source URL, if we open it, we see the actual shorts.
Are you riding maybe the AI hype train at all?
Let's go back to n8n. Let's rename it real quick. And go back to canvas. Like before, we want also to make sure here that we only continue once the status is ready. For that, we click here the plus icon, type in if, and get an if note. Here we drag and drop the status to value 1 and say it has to be equal to ready. We click test step and we see we are under the true branch. If this is not true, we want to wait, like again, 15 seconds, and check again if the short is ready. Amazing, we got now our automation up and running, and now the fun part comes, the automation of publishing these shorts. The first thing we want to do is to add a schedule date. For that, we click the plus icon and type in code and select this code node. Don't worry, we won't write any code. Just go back to the Google Docs document and under calculate schedule days, copy this whole snippet. Go back to n8n and replace everything here with this snippet and click test step. When we click here on table, we see all scheduled dates. So for the 4th, we have one, for the 5th, since we have two shorts. By the way, if you wonder how I created this snippet, I did it with ChatGPT by asking to schedule one short per day. It's super handy. Now let's go back to Canvas. To publish our shorts, we use a service called Brotato. For that, we go back to our Google Docs document and click the URL here. Simply create an account and log in. Then go to settings and collect all your social media accounts that you want. Once that's done, head back to our n8n and create a new HTTP request node. First, we need to upload the short to Brotato. For that, we go back to our Google Docs document and under upload to Brotato, we copy and paste the snippet here under import curl. First, we need to replace our API key with the Brotato one. For that, we go to Brotato, under settings, we scroll down here to API access and copy the key. And go back here and paste it. Then we scroll down here and replace the source URL with our actual one that we can find here. And click test that. Now we got our response from Brotato with our new URL for the video. Next, we will schedule the shorts. For that, we go back to Canvas. For that, we click the plus icon and type in HTTP request. This step works the same across all platforms. I'll show you TikTok as an example. Go to Google Docs and copy this snippet under schedule TikTok and click here import. Replace again the API key, then scroll down here and click under JSON expression and click this little icon. First, replace the TikTok ID you can find in Brotato settings. Copy the account ID and paste it here. Then we need to add our captions that we can find here. And our new media URL we just received from Brotato. Drag and drop it here. Last but not least, we need also to add our schedule date. We can find here. Close it here and click test step. Now our shorts got successfully scheduled. Let's see in Brotato. Here we go under calendar and see our scheduled posts. And here you can see a full breakdown for the cost for this workflow. So basically it's 90 cents per short and around 5 cents per scheduling a post. Feel free to pause the video and see it in more detail. And if you want this automation quickly up and running and in a more advanced version, then join my community to get the templates. Because then you can simply import the workflow and you're good to go. You just need to replace the API keys. I highly appreciate if you click like and subscribe. See you in the next one.